guys, this is Sonali, the Melodramatic Bookworm. Welcome back to my channel. In this wrap-up video, I'll be sharing with you all the books that I read in May. If I thought April was crazy with 13 books, May was even crazier. I read 16 books in this month and I couldn't be happier. Wow, 16 books in a month? That feels incredible actually. But May was a very versatile month for me, if you could use that word in this context. Because I read some very good books and then I read some average ones and then there were a couple that I didn't like. So you can see how that word comes into play here. But to be fair, it was a good mix of both. Because without the bad ones, how do I know the good ones? So before I decide not to share my reviews because it's getting too hot in here, let's get started with the video. Read in the month of May was The Trail of Four by Manjari Prabhu. Manjari Prabhu is apparently called the Indian Agatha Christie and Shashi Tharoor called her India's answer to Dan Brown. So I was obviously very intrigued and wanted to find out whether this book was worth all the hype of the author. Ray Barkar is an investigative journalist who gets psychic visions of things that are about to happen. Bad things that are about to happen. This time it's set in Salzburg, Austria, where the Schloss Leopold's throne is under threat. Ray, along with historian Isabel, has to solve the Trail of Four that was set 75 years ago by a Jewish director called Max Reinhardt and save the town. There were things that I liked and things that I didn't like in this book. The ones that I didn't like were the narrative. Sometimes became too descriptive and sometimes became too perfect. So at one point, I couldn't decide if it was the descriptiveness that stopped me from loving this book, or was it the perfection that stopped me from hating it? The solving of the clues in this book is sort of stagnant when it comes to the conversations between Ray and Isabel, because they keep talking and talking and talking and then they come back to the same point, which is I don't understand what's going on. And when Ray talks, it reminded me a lot of Poirot, which I'm not sure is a good thing because it sort of didn't live up to that reputation. But those were the things that I didn't like about it. The things that I liked and quite enjoyed was the extent of the research that was done for this book and the plot development that happened about halfway, until which it was dragging and dragging with Ray and Isabel having 10-page conversations about how the clue didn't make any sense to them. But after halfway, the plot sort of picked up and I had an enjoyable time reading it. I wrote a full review of The Trail of Four for Writer's Melon, which I will link down in the description. I gave The Trail of Four 3.5 out of 5 stars. The second book that I read for me was Dear Ijeavale, or A Feminist Manifesto in 15 Suggestions by Chimamanda Ngozi Adichie. I realize that I pronounce her name a different way each time, but I'll get the right way soon. This book, Dear Ijeavale, is a letter written by the author to her friend who had written to her asking for advice on how to raise a feminist daughter. And what a job she does in the 66 pages of this book. It is very thin. You can finish it in about an hour or so, but it took me a couple of hours to finish it because I was soaking in the words of wisdom. Chimamanda Adichie's words of wisdom are a must read for all genders. The reason why Chimamanda Adichie's words of wisdom work is because she has solid reasons and explanations for her thoughts. You just can't refute them. And I fell so much in love with this book that now I carry it around wherever I go. And I've been recommending it to friends and whoever I come in contact with. The other thing is, if I'm at home, it's on my bedside. If I'm going out, it's in my bag. I gave Dear Ijeavale a full 5 out of 5 stars and that still isn't enough. The third book that I read in May is Straight Drive by Sunil Gavaskar. Straight Drive is not an autobiography as many people think it to be. Even I thought it was an autobiography, but it's actually a collection of his 61 best columns and it was compiled for his 61st birthday. I knew Sunil Gavaskar doesn't mince his words, but even Straight Drive was a big surprise for me. Sunil Gavaskar's writing is to the point, hilariously analogical, it's honest and it's revealing. Sunil Gavaskar has clear ideas about what's right and what's wrong. if he thinks that someone's behavior is abysmal or if he thinks that something is wrong, then he's going to take them down without a thought. And I love this about the man. I gave Straight Drive 4 out of 5 stars. The fourth book that I read in the month of May was Ballad of a Bell by Rahul Tushar. Ballad of a Bell is about Aarti Pandit, a Kashmiri Pandit who faces turmoil in all aspects of her life. How she deals with the romantic failings of her partners forms the story of Ballad of a Bell. While in a number of places I found the writing to be choppy, on the whole, however, I found the plot and the story to be fast-paced and quite engaging. I gave Ballad of a Bell 3.5 out of 5 stars. The fifth book was Agatha Christie's Poirot's Early Cases. Agatha Christie has been one of my most favorite authors ever since I can remember. And Hercule Poirot, with his egg-shaped head and his usual airs of self-importance, is my absolute favorite alongside the usual suspect, Mr. Sherlock Holmes. Poirot's Early Cases is a collection of short stories in which Poirot solves cases like this. His genius is brought forward by Agatha Christie's genius writing. While some stories are predictable, you'll only feel vindicated at the end of them and not bored at all. And I absolutely love this collection. The only thought that went through my mind is, what if Chacha Chaudhary and Hercule Poirot were pitted against each other? Who would win? We couldn't know. I gave this book a full 5 out of 5 stars. The sixth book is Riders Mellon's Jukebox. This collection of 15 short stories is a very, very enjoyable one. I finished it in less than a day actually. It is that riveting. It starts off with a disturbing story called Story by Abhishek Dasgupta and ends with a grim story called Cycles and Cyclones by Archana Sarath. I have to say after I read this book that I'm so proud of Riders Mellon. I gave Riders Mellon's Jukebox 4 out of 5 stars. The seventh book that I read is Lightweight by Kirsty McManus. Lightweight is a Sophie Kinsella-esque story of rediscovery and self-improvement. Isla Greenwood is going through a bad patch. She's found a nude photo of herself online, which she knows is no thanks to her ex-boyfriend. And to comfort herself, she withdraws from society, she starts eating, she finds comfort in food, and by the end of it all, she's put on 25 kilos. And now that she realizes that she's gained too much weight, she knows she has to stop. So she enlists the help of her cousin, Grace, to help her shed all the weight and help her gain some self-confidence. And before she knows it, she's on track. Her personal life gets exciting when Wes enters it. Wes is a cute personal trainer who she takes as inspiration to work out and get on track with her life. I wanted to love this book because the blurb and the summary seems so interesting. And so much could have been made out of this plot, this exact storyline. But in the end, all it was a breezy read that you could finish in 4 to 5 hours. And even at the end, not everything was tied up. I gave Lightweight 3 out of 5 stars. The 8th book is Men and Dreams in the Dholadhar by Kocheri C. Shibu. Men and Dreams in the Dholadhar is the story of three central characters. Nanda from Kerala, Rekha from Punjab and Khusro from Kashmir. Everyone is dealing with their past when they arrive at the Heidelpower project at the foot of the Dholadhar range. But will they be able to escape from their past? Or will they be able to deal with it forms the rest of the story. The book is exhausting to read to say the least. There is so much of construction jargon in the book and there's so much description and so many characters at all points in the story that it becomes tiring and all you want to do is put the book down and forget all about it. But there's a big but. If you're in the construction industry, you will like this book because you will understand better what's going on there. And on the whole, it is actually successful in evoking emotions throughout the story. Because the moment you think, why is this going on? The emotions come into play. I gave Men and Dreams in the Dholadhar 4 out of 5 stars. Book number 9 is A Century is Not Enough by Saurabh Ganguly. I had always thought of Saurabh Ganguly as arrogant and I don't know, mannerless perhaps. But I'd also seen that his behavior on field and off field was completely different. On field, he was aggressive and opinionated and arrogant. And off field, he was a very shy, I won't speak if I'm not spoken to kind of guy. Maybe that's just my opinion. But I grew up thinking of Saurav Ganguly like that. So it's maybe the child in me that couldn't see why he was like that. And it's only now when I've grown up and I look back on all of it that I think, is being strong-headed really such a bad thing? And I think, no, it's not. And Saurav Ganguly opens up in this book to a degree where you think, oh my god. But in some places I found him a little cryptic. He didn't elaborate on them. Maybe he assumed that everyone who reads this book is going to be a cricket fan, an ardent cricket fan, who can recollect names and statistics very easily. But about Greg Chappell, he is very vocal. He literally brings him down. And I felt so sorry for this man. I felt so bad. I don't think sorry is the right word. I felt bad for him because for no fault of his, he was subject to all that he went through. And his anger and his hurt shows in this book. It bleeds. I like this book, even though in a lot of places it goes into the I, me, myself, I am the king of the world sort of thing. Because there are a lot of things that happened to him that should not have happened, and that sort of balances it out. I gave A Century Is Not Enough 4 out of 5 stars. Book number 10 was Demons in My Mind by Ashish Gupta. I'd been wanting to read this book for a long time because of the enlightenment about mental illness that his book offered. And when I received a review copy from the author, I was really ecstatic. Demons in My Mind is about three people, Rizwan, Murli and Joseph. Each of them has their own share of problems like everyone in this world has. But this book describes how it feels to be boxed in within one's own mind. It is dark, it has a nuanced writing style, it is graphically grating and disturbing, and it gives you a rush that you probably wouldn't have wanted to experience. If I had any complaints from this book, they were overshadowed by the fast-paced narrative and the honesty with which the author has written it. I gave Demons in My Mind 4 out of 5 stars. Book number 11 is Dort, The Incredible Adventures of Robin Einstein Varghese by Sirin Vadakkut. This is the first in the Dort trilogy, which I'd been wanting to read for a long time. I think I say that about every book, don't I? It's the story of Robin Einstein Varghese and how highly he thinks of himself. His adventures are mostly because of his incompetent, overconfident and stupid decisions, and he ends up paying for them obviously. I was excited to read these books because I'd heard so much about them and that they were so hilarious. But by the end of the book, I was really, really annoyed by Robin Einstein Varghese. I felt like I could give him a roundhouse kick if I could. It may make you chuckle in some places, but it's not the rolling on the floor laughing kind of book. And coming back to my irritation with Varghese, maybe that's the whole point of this book, isn't it? An overconfident dork who doesn't know right from idiocy. I give Dork number 1 3 out of 5 stars. Book number 12 is Persepolis, The Story of a Childhood and the Story of a Return by Marjan Satrapi. I'd been wanting to read this graphic novel for such a long time now because it came highly recommended, and also because of its intriguing cover. And now that I finally read it, I feel amazing. I'm so glad that I chose to read this. Or should I say the book chose me? Persepolis is an autobiographical account of the author, her life in war-torn Iran, her journey to Vienna and her life there, and her return to Tehran and what happens thereafter. That forms Persepolis. Her parents and grandmother, who are very supportive of her at all points, stay with her by her side during whatever she goes through, and it is with that confidence that she goes on in life. The illustrations are simple and majestic. I'll show you some. The characters that are actual real people are a shade of feminist. It talks of selfishness, racism, belief in God, self-confidence, social classes, forgiveness, and so much more. And despite the variety of topics that it talks about in its 350 odd pages, it leaves you feeling empty in the end for some strange reason. I fell in love with Persepolis the way you fall asleep, slowly and then all at once. Yeah, that's a fault in our stars line. I give Persepolis 4.5 out of 5 stars. Book number 13 is Cantilever Tales by Jayant Kriplani. Written by artist Jayant Kriplani, who is a film, TV and theatre actor, Cantilever Tales is the story of Khokon Lahiri and the people around him. The writing is simple and easy to read. There is enough humor and wit to make you chuckle quite a few times, and it tells you about the quirks of everyday people, everyday ordinary people. Cantilever Tales is a beautiful book, but there is something missing in the narrative that I can't quite put a finger on. So maybe if I read it again, I'll know, but I don't think that's going to happen anytime soon. But I gave Cantilever Tales 4 out of 5 stars. Book number 14 was Honor Among Thieves by Jeffrey Archer. Jeffrey Archer is a genius storyteller, as we all know. But Honor Among Thieves, there was something wrong with it. It started off palely, nothing worthwhile happened in the first 100-200 pages. And I was simply bored. This was not the Jeffrey Archer I know. The characters seem all over the place, the events are confusing, and half the time I was going, why? Why did Jeffrey Archer write something like this, and how did he write it, more importantly? But halfway in, the book redeems itself, and I heaved a sigh of relief. Because if I hadn't liked this book, I would have felt so let down, because Jeffrey Archer is one of my favorite authors. But the familiar quickening of my heartbeat, the adrenaline rush, it all felt so familiar reading Honor Among Thieves, finally that it came through, that I felt hopeful that the book wouldn't let me down, that I would have a satisfactory ending. All in all, I liked Honor Among Thieves, but not as much as I would have liked to like the book. Does that make sense? I give Honor Among Thieves 3.5 out of 5 stars. Book number 15, Two Women by Christine A. Brown. I got an e-copy of this book from NetGalley, and I don't really remember what it was about this book that pulled me in. Maybe it was the cover, maybe it was a blurb, but I actually thought it was going to be good. Two Women is actually about three women. While Bernice Archer lives with her two blind middle-aged daughters called Eva and Ava, she can see what's going on in the lives of two other women, Violet and Rose, in her dreams. Violet and Rose eventually come and live in the same building as Bernice and her daughters. So Violet and Rose get married to men that they thought were good men, but they find out later, much later, through abuse and whatnot, just like their mothers did. How these two women fight them back and find justice through it all forms the rest of the story. I was angry, I was sorry, I was happy, I was sad as I read Two Women, but mostly, I was annoyed by the twins, Eva and Eva, because instead of behaving like two middle-aged women, they're supposed to be 53 years old, for God's sake. They were behaving like hormonal teenagers, and that was not something I was comfortable with. The story of abuse and neglect could have been so much more. It could have been put forward in such a better manner. But it drops heavily in some places and it sort of becomes repetitive, which is not something I like. But if you want to go ahead and read this book, then I suggest you go ahead without any expectations, because that's obviously the better way out. I give Two Women 2.5 out of 5 stars. The last book that I read in May was The Story of My Experiments with Truth by Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi. I really don't want to talk about this book because I feel that it will create unnecessary controversy among the circles who are going to watch this video or read it. But I think I need to tell you how I felt. The thing about Gandhi is that I had little respect for him. Agreed that he was instrumental in bringing us our freedom, but the way he thought of himself, his ideas of himself, and the way he looked at people around him, it sort of dug the grave for my respect for him. What I could understand from this book is that he thought of himself as a saint, that everyone around him was stupid not to understand his ideals, and everyone around him had to follow whatever he said without questioning him. At one point, he said to the effect that intelligent people won't have a problem in understanding him. So, would that mean that people who didn't understand were stupid and dumb? Like half the population in the world wouldn't understand what he's saying. I don't want to talk anymore about this book because it angered me so much. But I gave my experiments with truth 2 out of 5 stars. So those are the books I read in May. Did you read any of these books? Which ones did you read and which ones did you like and which ones didn't you like? Let me know in the comments below. I'd love to hear from you. And if you like this video, please like it and share to spread the word. And if you like my content and would like to see more from me, don't forget to hit subscribe and click on the bell icon beside the subscribe button to get notifications as and when I upload new videos. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video. Until next time, keep reading, keep watching, and add melodrama to your life.